Bombshell. Hillary bribed them with $700,000. Rot in prison. Not one to mince words, President Donald Trump let FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe have it in a series of tweets on Saturday and Sunday accusing him of rampant corruption in the investigation of former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's private email server. In addition to revelations that two top FBI staffers exchanged pro-Clinton, anti-Trump text messages, McCabe remains under investigation by the Justice Department's Inspector General for how he handled the FBI's probe of Hillary Clinton's private email server. This comes after McCabe's closed-door testimony in front of congressional committees this week. President Trump asks Dash. How can FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, the man in charge, along with Leak and James Comey, of the phony Hillary Clinton investigation, including her 33,000 illegally deleted emails, be given $700,000 for a wife's campaign by Clinton puppets during investigation? He followed with news that McCabe is planning to retire in a few months when he becomes eligible for his government pension in 2018. McCabe announced his retirement after a disastrous round of congressional testimony, where he reportedly failed to answer basic questions about his connections with the anti-Trump Russian dossier and the investigation of Hillary Clinton's private email server. In a 7-hour interview with the House Intelligence Committee Wednesday, McCabe repeatedly declined to answer even the most basic of questions with regard to whether the Bureau has been able to verify the substantive allegations in the now infamous Trump dossier. McCabe failed to identify a single substantive allegation that has been corroborated throughout his lengthy hearing. President Trump's tweet reads Dash. FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe is racing the clock to retire with full benefits. 90 days to go? President Trump also accused McCabe of political bias in the investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails. He cites McCabe's use of his official FBI email account to promote his wife Dr. Jill McCabe to promote her political campaign in her 2015 bid for Virginia State Senate, as well some questionable donations to the tune of approximately $675,000. Jill's campaign received donations from former Democratic National Committee Chairman Terry McAuliffe's Super PAC, as well as the Democratic Party of Virginia. McAuliffe is a Democrat with long-standing ties directly to Bill and Hillary Clinton. President Trump tweeted Dash. At Fox News FBI's Andrew McCabe, in addition to his wife getting all of this money from M. Clinton puppet, he was using, allegedly, his FBI official email account to promote her campaign. You obviously cannot do this. These were the people who were investigating Hillary Clinton. Twitter.com web link. McAuliffe's Political Action Committee ponied up $467,500 to Jill's campaign, and the Virginia Democratic Party gave more than $200,000 at a time when McCabe headed the FBI's Washington field office. That same field office provided the manpower for the investigation into Hillary's secret email system. McCabe would later be promoted to the third-ranking post at the FBI, and then named deputy. Jill ran to unseat sitting Republican Senator Dick Black. His ouster would have swung control of the Virginia State Senate to Democrats. Black ultimately won the senatorial election and states it was his belief McCabe should resign from his post over what he and many others view as a significant bias or conflict of interest. 0. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. Not one to mince words. President Donald Trump let FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe have it in a series of tweets on Saturday and Sunday accusing him of rampant corruption in the investigation of former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's private email server. In addition to revelations that two top FBI staffers exchanged pro-Clinton, anti-Trump text messages, McCabe remains under investigation by the Justice Department's Inspector General for how he handled the FBI's probe of Hillary Clinton's private email server. This comes after McCabe's closed-door testimony in front of congressional committees this week. President Trump asks Dash. How can FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, the man in charge, along with Leak and James Comey, of the phony Hillary Clinton investigation, including her 33,000 illegally deleted emails, Be given $700,000 for wife's campaign by Clinton puppets during investigation. Donald J. Trump. At Real Donald Trump. How can FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, the man in charge, along with Leak and James Comey, of the phony Hillary Clinton investigation, including her 33,000 illegally deleted emails, be given $700,000 for wife's campaign by Clinton puppets during investigation? 8:27 p.m., December 23, 2017. 34,604 34,604 replies 34,768 34,768 retweets 115,408 115,408 likes. Twitter ads, info and privacy. He followed with news that McCabe is planning to retire in a few months when he becomes eligible for his government pension in 2018. McCabe announced his retirement after a disastrous round of congressional testimony, where he reportedly failed to answer basic questions about his connections with the anti-Trump Russian dossier and the investigation of Hillary Clinton's private email server. In a 7-hour interview with the House Intelligence Committee Wednesday, McCabe repeatedly declined to answer even the most basic of questions with regard to whether the Bureau has been able to verify the substantive allegations in the now infamous Trump dossier. McCabe failed to identify a single substantive allegation that has been corroborated throughout his lengthy hearing. President Trump's tweet reads dash. FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe is racing the clock to retire with full benefits. 90 days to go? Donald J. Trump. At Real Donald Trump. FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe is racing the clock to retire with full benefits. 90 days to go? 8:30 p.m., December 23, 2017. 23,980 23,980 replies 20,314 20,314 retweets 69,519 69,519 likes. Twitter ads, info and privacy. President Trump also accused McCabe of political bias in the investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails. He cites McCabe's use of his official FBI email account to promote his wife Dr. Jill McCabe to promote her political campaign in her 2015 bid for Virginia State Senate, as well some questionable donations to the tune of approximately $675,000. Jill's campaign received donations from former Democratic National Committee Chairman Terry McAuliffe's Super PAC, as well as the Democratic Party of Virginia. McAuliffe is a Democrat with long-standing ties directly to Bill and Hillary Clinton. President Trump tweeted dash. Dot at Fox News FBI's Andrew McCabe, in addition to his wife getting all of this money from M. Clinton puppet, he was using, allegedly, his FBI official email account to promote her campaign. You obviously cannot do this. These were the people who are investigating Hillary Clinton. Twitter.com web link. McAuliffe's political action committee ponied up $467,500 to Jill's campaign, and the Virginia Democratic Party gave more than $200,000 at a time when McCabe headed the FBI's Washington field office. That same field office provided the manpower for the investigation into Hillary's secret email system. McCabe would later be promoted to the third-ranking post at the FBI, and then named deputy. Jill ran to unseat sitting Republican Senator Dick Black. His ouster would have swung control of the Virginia State Senate to Democrats. Black ultimately won the senatorial election and states it was his belief McCabe should resign from his post over what he and many others view as a significant bias or conflict of interest. Image result for Jeannie Rhee. Black also revealed that many local Democrats in Virginia were irritated at what they perceived as McAuliffe hand-picking Jill to run for the seat, and he wonders just how much the money influenced the FBI's investigation into Hillary and her actions. Black states dash. It is kind of hard to imagine that a huge contribution of that magnitude to his wife would not consciously or subconsciously influence how he would decide the case. Now I can say for certain, but this is the reason that the ethical standards say you should avoid even the appearance of impropriety, because ordinary people looking at the facts would say this really stinks and this really, really smells of government corruption. McCabe has also exhibited a significant level of corruption and bias in other areas, acting against the best interests of the country. Many in the FBI have spoken of McCabe's penchant for carrying vendettas and believe that former Trump National Security Advisor Michael Flynn may have been targeted by McCabe due to Flynn's intervention in an agent sexual discrimination case against McCabe and other top officials. As previously reported by AFF, Flynn's intervention in the EOC, Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, case on behalf of Supervisory Special Agent Robin Gertz was highly unusual in and of itself. His intervention included a letter in 2014 on his official Pentagon station, as well as a public interview in 2015 supporting Gertz's case. He also extended an offer to testify on her behalf, making him a hostile witness against McCabe. McCabe was soaring through the Bureau's leadership ranks at the time. Flynn's testimony was so damaging the FBI sought to block Flynn's support for Agent Gertz. In May of 2014, they sought a federal administrative law judge to keep Flynn and others from becoming a witness in her EOC case. 2 years later, the FBI opened its inquiry of Flynn in timing that is suspect at best, given the EEOC claim is still pending. No less than three separate FBI employees, speaking only on condition of anonymity for fear of McCabe's retaliation, have stated that McCabe personally disparaged Flynn's character during the time the retired Army general emerged as a person of interest regarding the Russia matter. They did not understand nor know the source of McCabe's seeming hatred for Flynn, but it made them highly uncomfortable as the Russia probe began to unfold and the investigation began to focus on Flynn with almost single-minded obsession. One of the employees even sought independent counsel. It seems the level of corruption McCabe and others he surrounds him with knows no bounds. Follow us on Facebook at Freedom Daily.